there, friends. It is Miss Sarah, and this is my friend Gloria.
Gloria,
what's in your mouth?
This is a list of all the things my family's going to do this weekend. It's pretty long.
Did look pretty long.
Do you mind if I take a look?
Okay, let's see.
It says, mow the lawn, trim the trees, plant a garden, wash bikes.
Oh, I didn't know you liked to ride your bike.
I sure do. I'm learning to ride without training wheels. I know it's a long list, but I'm excited to do it together with my family. We always have so much fun when we work together and help each other out.
Well, did you know that the Bible actually tells us that we can help each other and encourage each other by praying together?
You mean I can help you by praying for you?
You sure can.
And this is the last week in our series all about prayer. So let's learn more, but first let's stand and sing and praise God together. Let's go.
Good morning, my name is Miss Kristen. I would love for you to stand and worship with me today. Worship is just praising God in every area of our lives. My favorite way to worship is to play music and sing. And Miss Alex is going to join us in a second, and she's going to do some movements with this song. I would love for you to stand and worship with me.
Hey everyone, will you stand and sing Every Move I Make?
Every move I make, I'm making you. You make me move, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. Every step I take in you. You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. I'm making you. You make me move, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. Every step I take in you. You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. La 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 la.
How can it be?
Learning all about prayer, which means talking to God. But first, let's take a look in the Bible and see what it has to say to us.
The Bible is the true word of God, written for us so that we can know God. I bet it tells us how we can pray together and help each other.
It sure does. And one of the ways the Bible does that is in Colossians 3:16. So let me grab my Bible and we'll read it together. Okay, so it says right here, "Let the message about Christ live among you like a rich treasure. Teach and correct one another wisely. Teach one another by singing psalms and hymns and songs from the Spirit. Sing to God with thanks in your hearts."
The message of Jesus is a rich treasure, like a treasure of gold or diamonds or even an apple pie.
Well, I would say the message about Jesus is better than all of that, better than gold or diamonds or even apple pie. And when we celebrate together what Jesus has done for us and we tell each other what we're learning in the Bible, it reminds us how much God loves us.
You know, I think you might be right, because when I think about what Jesus has done for me and for everyone who trusts in him, it really does seem like the best treasure ever.
I agree, Gloria. And do you want to remind our friends just what Jesus has done for us?
I sure would. I love telling people about Jesus. Friends, Jesus lived a perfect life on earth. He did everything God asked him to do, and he never sinned. He never did or said things that hurt God and people. And then he died on the cross to pay for our sins. Our sins separate us from God, but Jesus took on that punishment for our sins. And then God raised him from the dead.
That's right. And when we trust in Jesus, he takes away our sins and makes us friends with God. And we're part of God's family forever.
And when we're part of God's family, we help each other out.
That's right. And God's family, the church family, loves and helps each other when we need it. Let's talk more, but first, let's do some drawing together. Come join us.
Hello, RIV kids. This is the last week of our prayer series. I have already learned so much, and I hope that you have too. Do you have your drawing supplies? Quick, pause the video and grab paper and coloring supplies if you need to. Okay, today we've been talking about praying together and worshiping with others through music. It is good to talk to God on your own, but the Bible also tells us that God loves when we talk to him and sing to him together with other Christians. Let's draw what that might look like. Okay, so today we're gonna draw some friends together with a cross and some music to remind us that worshiping and praying together is a great way to praise God. All right, so grab your drawing or coloring utensil. First, we're gonna draw some people here. So down here towards the bottom center of the paper, I'm gonna draw a circle or an oval. All right, and you can make the people look different any way that you want. So I'm gonna draw some eyes and a smile. And then maybe some bangs. I'll give her some. It's gonna be a lady with some pigtails. All right, and then over here to the right, I'm gonna draw another circle or oval. And another smile, and then maybe some hair like this on that one. And then over here to the left, we'll draw another person. Smiling. Maybe they're wearing their hair down. Okay, now in the middle, we're gonna draw a cross. So we're gonna start up at the top, draw a line straight down, and then start over here, and draw a line across. Now, we're gonna draw some music notes. So these are pretty simple, but if you mess up the first time, that's okay. So I'm gonna draw one over here. We're gonna draw two little ovals. And then we're gonna start at the back of this oval and make a line up, then across and down. And over here, we're just gonna draw an oval with a little stem, squiggly line coming from the top. Then we can draw some other music notes. Like that. Now I'm going to color. So I'm going to start with this color. Right. And here we go. Here are our friends praying and worshiping together. All right, I wonder what else the Bible has to tell us. Let's find out.
Before our break, we learned that when we put our trust in Jesus, He takes away our sins and He makes us part of God's family. And as members of God's family, we help each other out. Now back to the message.
Well, I love my family. And even though we're doing work, we're doing it together. So it makes it more fun. And we get to talk a lot while we do it, and it makes us feel closer to each other. Plus, it makes me feel good to help. Yeah, so did you know that when we pray together, it's a lot like that. We get to share with each other what we need prayer for, and we get to feel more part of each other's lives. We can encourage each other by reminding one another what God tells us in the Bible.
And when we pray and talk to God together, it reminds us that God is in control and that He hears us. And it reminds us that we're part of a big family who loves each other.
I know that whenever I feel worried about something, I talk to my family about it and my friends, and I know they'll pray for me. It helps me feel loved, knowing that other people are talking to God with me and for me.
Hey, that reminds me of our memory verse. Philippians 4:6 says, "Don't worry about anything. No matter what happens, tell God about everything. Ask and pray, and give thanks to Him." Let's practice our memory verse together a couple times to help us remember. Let's say it with our eyes closed.
Oh, that's a great idea. Hey friends, can you repeat after me? Let's close our eyes. Okay, don't worry about anything. No matter what happens, tell God about everything. Ask and pray, and give thanks to Him. Nice job! Okay, let's try it in a voice that's like Gloria's. Can you try it with me? Okay, ready? I'll say it and you repeat.
Don't worry about anything. Don't worry about anything. No matter what happens, tell God about everything. Ask and pray, and give thanks to Him. Wow, you guys sounded just like me. You know, we don't have to worry about anything because we can pray and talk to God for ourselves and for each other. Trusting in Jesus gives us so many treasures. Jesus takes away our sins, He makes us friends with God, and He brings us into the church family who loves us.
I agree, Gloria. I know that my church family is there for me when I need them. And it's all because God loves us and He sent Jesus to save us from our sins.
Our takeaway this week is God's family loves and helps one another by talking to God together.
Thank you for joining us today, friends.
I hope you can check out the activities that go with our message.
Let's pray together. Ready? Dear God, thank you for your church family, for our brothers and sisters in Christ who can pray for us and care for us, all because you sent your Son, Jesus, to die for our sins. We love you so much. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
to say, my lips shall still ring. Jesus paid it all to him I owe. Sin had left the crimson stain. Jesus paid it all to